Hi, I'm Adam. I'm a part-time game developer. I got started in Houdini about 2 years ago now, when I decided to really take an interest in the 3D side of video game development. So I picked up the package as like a, you know, a way to let me actually sort of get into proper game development.
Yeah, hi. I'm Glenn. I'm a senior software engineer from Mountain View, California. We brainstormed a lot of different ideas for it. Adam had the vision for a picnic being attacked by ants, which we ended up liking the best. I wanted it to be messy because that's what I thought of when I think of food fights. And we wanted to capture that mess while also experimenting with players generating art as a product of their gameplay. We set up our fruit colors and the associated projectile effects to all stack as they go, which allowed us to create some emergent gameplay that could scale. And we use Codex to outline and prioritize our tasks.
Picnic Panic is it's a roguelite, top-down, shoot 'em up. You play as a snail, and ants come from all different directions and they try and steal your food from your picnic. And if you pick up the food, you get to improve your power-ups. You get lots of different abilities. And the whole goal is to avoid the ants and shoot the ants. And we have a kind of a fun, like a splatter effect that that paints a picture as you play. So as the game goes on, the arena that you're fighting in gets like really messy, and you kind of you make like a sort of abstract painting almost. I used Houdini for everything in the game, so I really wanted to sort of try and push myself to really make everything from the ground up, just for the jam, as a bit of a challenge and a fun exercise. So all the models in the game were done in Houdini. We've got lots of different fruits. So most fruits, they're kind of simple to model, really. Like you think of like an apple, a banana, they're kind of easy items to model. But then there's also some really complex fruits, like a dragon fruit. It's very intricate. We've got lychees, raspberries, that kind of stuff. And Houdini has some really good modeling tools to actually to make those sort of more complex ones. It's also good for the simple ones. And I ended up sort of making reusing a lot of sort of base geometry, like streams, to get the base shapes of a lot of the fruits. For example, like most of the fruits have they're driven by like a single curve and like a sweep node over the curve. So it's like a pretty quick and effective way of making geometry with like UVs and stuff in a quick fashion, which is very useful for a game jam. Other things that I specifically used Houdini for was the level generation. We have an arena which has obstacles throughout it. So using Houdini engine, you can like instance a point cloud of obstacles like randomly scattered. I used Houdini to rig the ants in our game. We have ants as the main enemy, so they've obviously got six legs, and rigging them up in Houdini is pretty simple. They're not skinned, they're just rigid rigs. And then inside Unity, I use the procedural rigging package so that they've got some nice IK foot solving going on. So they look quite organic, which was I was pretty pleased with. Also, Houdini, our main character, the snail, is built completely in Houdini, and it's nice to be able to sort of build your main model, and then if you're not quite happy with the dimensions of it or whatever, once you get to the end, you can go back and change it. That's like obviously a really good use of the procedural workflow in Houdini, which is exactly what I did, because when we first had the player character in, he was like, he didn't feel good, like he wasn't quite the right dimensions. So I went back in, changed some things, made him like have a better presence in the screen. The procedural workflow is really good for that.
all the assets, all the art assets in there were Houdini assets that Adam was handing over. I was kind of on the Unity side of things, deal with that side of the programming. So it was really easy working with the Houdini assets coming into Unity. They're like ready to go. They had parameters you could tweak if I needed to. Keep it simple, because you're going to have a lot of features that you want to put in that you just don't have time for. The first game jam I did was Loot 'Em Dare that Adam asked me to do a couple years ago, and I just wasn't prepared for that at all. We planned way too much for what we wanted, and we just weren't able to deliver it.
My advice would be to really try and get your game like working and demonstratively fun. Like, get that going as soon as possible, because it's easy to set your sights quite high and then like not really even have a game by like day three or day four, and that's really no good. You want to have like at least a game you can play by day one, hopefully, like and sort of test your concept out. It gives you more time to make changes later on. Using placeholder assets is like really important, and something that I've only recently learned to actually like really incorporate. Just like, you know, gray boxes everywhere is good to begin with, and then once it's fun, you can then swap those out and make it look nice.